What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today I want to show you a platform that's called Graphy. This one is by Unacademy, and what it does, it helps you launch your course with several tools that come along with it for all your course needs. Now, one of the things that I love about Graphy is that it's practically free. The only time that you actually have to pay something is when someone purchases your course. So what does that mean? Well, you can go to Graphy right now, open your account for free, upload your courses, set everything up, and don't pay anything unless someone purchases your course. So how cool is that, right? So like I said before, there are several tools that revolve around Graphy that help your course be successful. So let me show you what I'm talking about on my desktop right now. All right, guys, this is the Graphy homepage. And like I mentioned before, there's several tools that revolve around Graphy to make your course successful. So you have the system to upload your courses. You have the system for members area where you have their name, their email, and the list when they subscribed and all that good stuff. They also have an email system where you can schedule emails to send out to your members who subscribe. Plus, you can also go live. They have a live platform where you can go live, you can make a presentation, you have a whiteboard, you have the chat and polls and all that good stuff, all inside of Graphy. And like I mentioned before, everything is free. The only time that you have to pay something is when someone actually pays for your course. Now, let me show you a really quick profile from someone who's successful here on Graphy. Her name is Kamija Jani. Hope I'm saying it right. But she has her own community already set up with courses and everything. And we have the top profile. We have some quills, which I'll talk about in a bit. The information, join the community. With joining, you have Google and Facebook to log in or just using email. We have her social profiles right there. The courses that she has that she's offering right now. So for example, there's this course that she's offering for 2,000 rupees, for example, with a promotion going on right now. You can set up promotions, you can set up coupons, and I'll show you those in a bit. Like I said, it's a really good platform for your courses. Past sessions, featured media, testimonials, and quills. These are pretty cool because people who took your course and they are happy with the content, they can give you a bonus. So they pay a little bonus, plus they give you a quills. That quills, you can showcase them right here, plus it showcases their name and the information that they give you. So it's a testimonial plus a quill. So you know that this person does a good job. So there's copper quills, bronze quills, and those are available, all right? Video library, and that's it, right? This is available for Google Play and App Store, just so you guys know. Now, let's go jump over to my dashboard. This is my Graphy dashboard. It's super easy to get started. It's not complex at all. Let me show you what my profile looks like right now. Let me grab the link and let's check it out. Go into the main page. Right now, my link is saasmaster.graphy.com. This is my profile. There's my image, the information. Go to dashboard and because I'm logged in, but if not, it would say join my community, right? My courses that I'm offering, these are just demo right now. I'm still thinking about doing a YouTube starter course. If you guys are interested, let me know in the comments. So for demo purposes and past sessions, these are the live sessions that I did for testing. There's no quills because basically I haven't launched anything. And that's about it for this profile. But if I want to check out one of the courses, let's go check out this one, the YouTube one, all right? We got the header image, we got the information, the description. They can subscribe to this and we have information right here. All this is built automatically by adding simple steps. So you got the testimonials, you got course plan, information, for example, guest lectures for experts, dedicated questions for answers and sessions, case studies. We can activate or deactivate any one of these. Build your portfolio, internship, so on and so forth. So it's a really good looking page where you can check out the courses and people decide if they want to join or not. Let me go back to my dashboard. All right, let's go back again. And all right, we're back. Let's go into the audience section to get started. This is where we're going to see all our subscribers, the course members, they're gonna be listed down here. Cool feature, we can import and export mailing lists via CSV. We can also compose an email. Like I said before, we can send out an email to certain people or all the verified members of the course. We can send it now and schedule. So it's a pretty cool tool that we have available right here without having to go to an email marketing service. We can do it right from there really easily. All right. And next thing we have is the revenue. In this case, I don't have any revenue because I haven't launched, but you have the information right there. And we have all the scheduled information right here. These are the sessions I've made for testing, but we will view them right here all the schedules, and we can schedule one right now. All right, let's go into home. Sessions, we can start them right here. Let's get started with courses. I think this would be the main feature and why most people would use it are the courses. So I can open up a new course, but let's go quicker by opening one I already created. So first off, we have the overview, all right? So it's the main information, the course name, course page URL. We can edit this if we like. Describe the course, so here's the description for it. The duration of it, so when does it start and when does it end? What will your audience learn in this course? So you can add many things right here. These are all demo things that I just added, but we can add more. For example, we can add more and more. And these will showcase in the homepage for this specific course. The enrollment fee, so how much is this course going to cost? In this case, I put 100. We can set a maximum seats available, so we can make this limited to say, hey, you know what? Course only available for 10 people, or 100, or 1,000 like I did right there. Select enrollment closing date, so if you want to add a closing date to this, the time zone that this is for, and pick a course enrollment button. So there's several buttons that we can check. For example, enroll now for $100, right? It's open until blah, blah, blah. But we have different type of buttons available. So we can choose this one, and there's different. So here we're telling that we have 1,000 seats available, and so many seats are left. I wish we could edit this right here so we can say how many seats are left, because I mean, if there's 1,000 and someone just opens up this and they say, hey, they still have 999 available. So maybe this is not a good course. So it would be cool if we can edit this to kind of say, you know what, so many are left. But we can use other systems where it doesn't say how many users are available, seats. So there's these available right there. Next, we set the plans for this course. So in this case, I just added this. Let's get started, upload basics, and we can add more modules to this. Everything that we added here updates over there for each individual course. The media for this course. So for example, in this case, I just added this image, which is the media there. We can add a video if we like. Frequently asked questions. So how can I contact you? Will I learn how to monetize? Yes, and we can add more questions, which are, I want to show you really quickly. No, let's finish and then I'll open up the course. Testimonials, this is where you would add them. Just added some lorem ipsum information. So I added three of them. We can add more if we like. The offerings, so remember we saw sections on the homepage for the course. Well, we can enable or disable these. I wish we could edit individually these, what they say, but I think that's not available yet. Hope they plan to implement that. The payments, for now, they have two payment gateway systems. Oh, God. One was for India and Stripe, which is practically worldwide. Those are the ones that are available. Hope they add PayPal, which is, I don't like using PayPal, but basically that's what most people like to use. So I wish they implement that soon. We can view the community for this one where we can chat with them. For example, let me open it up right now. We can send out community messages right here where everyone would see them. The members, the channels, it's gonna be general, announcements, or random, and we can send them there. It's pretty cool that we have this community system, which is something they just implemented. So that means it's gonna get more powerful with time that comes by, right? The revenue for this course, there's no revenue right now. The promotions for this, we can add a sale for your course, so for the price, for example, start a sale. We can say it's $50, right? So that means it's equivalent to a 50% discount. When does it start? When does it end? How many seats are going to be at a sale price? We could say only first 10 seats, all right? We can also create coupons. For example, if I want to create a coupon, again, we could say the coupon is for $30. So they get a 70% discount and it's only gonna be available for 100 seats and the start date and end date. So now we have a coupon available plus a sale that's going on based on time frame. So all that available right there. The course settings. So you can have this setting as a graphic classroom or as a standard mode. A standard mode would be like the interface like Zoom, Google Meet, you can see that right there, and the classroom, which be like the course, right? With where the class goes on. Now let's go actually check it out. View the course. Here's the main image, description. You saw the information there. What we learn, remember we can add these, we can add more or remove. The testimonials, I added three. You can add more or remove. The course plan, you can see how everything ties from the settings over there on Graphy. The information there. You can enable these or disable them. This is where I mentioned where I hope we could edit this right here, but that's not available right now. Hope they plan to implement that. The live sessions and the information. Super easy to get started, all right? So that's how you create courses. You just start creating your courses as much as and as many as you need, and it's super easy to do. We can view the course information from all the ongoing, draft, upcoming, completed, and archived. And we have the really cool feature, which is a live session. Let me start one really quickly. Let me add, Let's just add that. All right. We'll keep it like that. We'll just say test, test for description. And right now it's 431. So let me start it at 432. So it gets started really quickly, PM. And it could be a free session or a paid session. In this case, we'll keep it free. Okay, let's get started. And it's going to start in 30 seconds. So let me copy this invite link and open it up. Okay, we're opening up our live session right now, just to show you what this looks like. Okay, so we can select the camera that we're going to use. In this case, I'm just gonna use the MacBook's camera and the default microphone. So let's go ahead and done. All right, so you just view me here and I'm live. I have options for the chat, so we can view here. So chat with me, ask questions, blah, blah, blah. When members join in, they can chat there. We can start a poll. So for example, do you like Graphy? Just for example, we can say yes, no, hey. No, and save the poll and start it when we want, okay? We got the members area where we're gonna see them listed there. We have the option, obviously you're viewing the camera right now, I'm going live. We can do a whiteboard, so we can draw on the whiteboard. We can open up the tools right here. We can highlight, we can choose the color, we can erase, we can use shapes, and we can clear all. Clear, yes. We also have the option for presentation. So let me load in a presentation really quickly. Okay, our presentation has just been loaded. Let's go ahead and start. We can also use tools here. So here's the presentation. I'm gonna go to the next page. Next page, all right, there we go. Here's the presentation. We can open up our tools right now again. So let's just say we wanna highlight something and say, hey, you know what? I'm talking about what's going on there and we can highlight it. Yes, this is what I'm talking about. Just an example. Change the color, we can erase, we can draw. So hey, check this out, guys. Shapes, this is what's important. And just highlight things that you want from the tools there. So you have that tool to go live. Let's go back to our homepage, go back to our dashboard. And basically that is Graphy, all right? You can upload your courses, you can go live, you can send out emails, you can view your revenue, you can view your members area where you can grab the emails, send them emails, and just be in touch with the subscribers of your course with Graphy. So that's pretty cool that you have all those options. And like I mentioned before, it's free. The only time they have to pay something is when someone actually buys your courses. Things that I wish they implemented, at least if it's a small payment, for example, if we can have our own custom domain, so we can connect it via DNS to have our own domain and not use, in my case, I'm using saasmaster.graphy.com. I maybe have my own custom domain if they would make that available. Other things like, for example, branding, if we can reduce branding, or pay for removal branding, things that I wish that they would have available. But at the end of the day, I'm fine if someone sees Graphy because it's a good platform. The thing works, right? So if I do plan to start a course, let me know in the comments what you guys think, if I should start a course or something. So, well, that is Graphy, guys. If you guys wanna check out the deal that's going on right now, that will be in the description. I don't wanna say it here because obviously, it's gonna be expired at a certain time, so you gotta check it out in the comments. Well, I thank you all for watching. My name's George, this is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.